Back in Scala 2, there was some inconsistency in how a new instance of a class could be created. The regular Java-like way in Scala 2 is to use the new keyword to call the primary constructor. The primary constructor creates the instance and initializes class fields, and we may use that feature to implement additional, albeit limited, logic into the initialization procedure. We are also able to write secondary constructors. If we do that, we have to call the primary constructor or another secondary one in the first line, and only later are we allowed to add some custom logic. This could be useful for logging, for example. On the other hand, it prevents us from verifying and modifying the data given in constructor parameters before the instance is created. If I write val cat equals new cat fluffy minus 2, Scala will happily create an instance of the cat fluffy, which is minus 2 years old. To overcome this limitation, Scala introduced apply methods. We can write an apply method in the companion object of our class, and then, instead of calling cat apply, we can just write cat. Now, we can make our primary constructor private, or not, but I like to do it to keep the code clean. We can delete the secondary constructor and instead write our own apply methods. And since apply is a regular method with no constructor limitations, we can verify the cat's age before creating the instance. So let's check the age of our cat, and if it's smaller than 0, we will just use age 0 instead. Now let's run it. And yes, now Fluffy is not a bug, but just a very small kitten. Now, pay attention to this part here. If I comment out the companion object for a moment and start writing C, IntelliJ IDEA with the Scala plugin will show me a pop-up with possible code completions, but there will be no cat on the list. This is because without an apply method in the companion object, I have to use the new keyword to create a new instance. If I do that, yay, the code completion pop-up shows cat. I choose it and I get the whole name and the parentheses. But if I uncomment the companion object now, IntelliJ IDEA will display cat on the list. That's just the name of the companion object, by the way, not the apply method yet. If I choose it and then write the opening parentheses myself, IntelliJ IDEA will notice that I want to use the apply method and display a hint about what parameters are needed. You can also notice that I help myself with the parameters completion feature from IntelliJ IDEA with the Scala plugin. If I type the first letter of the first parameter, IntelliJ IDEA shows a pop-up with possible code completions. I choose the one with parameter names, then fill the highlighted box with the value, that is the cat's name, then I press tab, which takes me to the next highlighted box, I type in the age and press tab again, and I am done. So, now we have apply methods and can create instances without the new keyword. On top of that, Scala introduced case classes, which have companion objects and apply methods generated under the hood. We call them synthetic. We can still write them by hand, but if we don't need them, we can just let the Scala compiler generate them for us. And so here we have that inconsistency. In a large Scala project, we will have case classes, classes with companion objects and apply methods, and classes without them. Also, some Scala projects rely heavily on Java libraries, and Java classes are treated in Scala as regular classes without apply methods. So, when we want to create a new class instance, we need to check whether we should use the new keyword. Scala 3 provides a solution to this problem by introducing universal apply methods. If no apply method is already written by the developer, the Scala 3 compiler will generate them for any class, be it Scala or Java. So now, in Scala 3, we don't have to use the new keyword almost anywhere. It's basically only ever required when we want to explicitly call the constructor and an apply method exists with the same list of parameters. as that constructor. If you want even more details, check out the official documentation on the Scala website. I will put the link down below. IntelliJ IDEA with the Scala plugin supports universal apply methods by recognizing when the developer tries to create an instance without using the new keyword for a regular class without any handwritten apply method. As you can see, I have a regular class cat here. I write val cat equals C, and IntelliJ IDEA displays the code completion pop-up with the generated cat apply method at the top. Note that this works only because the companion object and the apply method are synthetic, and IntelliJ IDEA with the Scala plugin can rely on that. If I code them by myself, we are back to the situation where IntelliJ IDEA will provide me with the object name, but I need to write the opening parentheses to indicate that I want to use the apply method. And that's all. Thanks for watching. To learn more about what IntelliJ IDEA can do for you, look for more videos like this one on our channel, like and subscribe, read our blog, or chat with the development team on our Discord server. Links in the description. Happy developing!